So this is really a celebration of you. Definitely want to talk about how great you are. Know, hopefully, if you don't know you're great, then you will know it after today, hopefully. First and foremost, oh, I have talking points, so I have to kind of read some things because Kathy said I gotta, you know, kind of get too long-winded up here. So, yeah. So, first and foremost, I want to thank our board of directors, very supportive board. We do have one member here, Dr. Jack. You stand up. So, really appreciate you showing up today. The board is here about with the spirit. They always talk about you, how great job you do. So, keep up the great work. Before I really get into it, I really want to send a special thank you to the planners who supported today's event. As you can see, it's wonderful. I didn't even recognize the day. So, great job. I want to acknowledge and say thank you to all involved. Special thank you to our HR team. The social committee. So the social committee is not just being social, they're playing stuff. The social committee. Our communications team, audio facilities, and the warehouse. Okay, thank you. So here's the things I'm going to talk about today. I'm going to talk about, you know, things that you've done in an outstanding way the past fiscal year. And then also I'm going to talk about the future of the service authority. So I've got this report up here, the annual accomplishments report. It's quite a bit of good information in it. You get a chance to take a look at it. Talks about all the great work you're doing. We measure a lot here. And I would say that we exceed expectations in pretty much everything too. Which I've never seen that until I got here. So great job to you all. I'll talk about some of those things that I think are notable, all right? So I just wanted you to know each of you contributes to this support work, both as individuals and teams. The true reflection of our one SA motto, servitory motto. First highlight I want to point out, as you know, folks were having a hard time during COVID, ratepayers, people lost jobs, things of that nature, loved ones, things changed, right? So using federal funds, we provided $1.5 million in bill relief to nearly 6,000 customers in need of relief. So that's a great job. Awesome. We also achieved 99.9998% water system reliability, also known as the 5-9. Y'all heard of that? I know some people have. So what does that mean? This acceptable metric means that on average, each customer experienced less than 2 minutes of outage time for the year in the water service. Outstanding. Also, our customer first focus earned us 9.1 out of 10 points on the annual customer satisfaction survey. So that speaks volumes. I tell you what, I probably get more praise from customers and emails, things of that nature about the customer service than I actually get complaints. I don't think I can't remember one complaint after. So that's a testament to you all. We continued our valued community partnerships, including presentations to over 10,000 students through the H2Go Kids Classroom. That's major. That's major. So we want to teach our up-and-comers and youth about what we do in the water industry. We want to get interested, and I want all of them to come work here at the service authority. So yes, that's great. It's all about bringing them up, providing us opportunities, and inspiring them. Great job. We earned the NACWA Platinum Peak Performance Award for the 13th consecutive year, placing us among the top wastewater treatment facilities in the entire nation. It's not easy. Folks make it look easy, but it's not. So congratulations on that. So proud of that. We also established the Project Management Office, also known as PMO, and increased our capital project execution rate to 70%. So when I got here, were much lower. Told the team we need to start spending the money. Find those infrastructure improvements that we promised to repair. So 7% is clearly exceeding my expectations to break out. That execution rate is a sign of our commitment to future investment needs for our county residents. We also enhanced our use of technology, including deploying the next phase of our work order management system and extensive cybersecurity initiatives. So one thing that keeps you up at night is cybersecurity. So I think we're on the right track. Great job to the IT team. And without an exceptional workforce, without our people, you, we couldn't get this done. So during the past year, we earned 4.3 out of 5 in employee engagement surveys. So I think that's great. You know, doing exactly what I want you to do. As we make decisions as a leadership team, I want to hear input from you all. I think you're doing a great job of that. I always tell folks that I don't know how to solve issues that I don't know about, right? So continue to be collaborative, communicate, and work together. Also, you know, I'm really proud to say that we promoted 57 employees, to highlight our commitment to retention and development. So we want to provide those growth opportunities here, and I see a lot of folks managing that, so great job. So these are just a few examples of many, many achievements from FY22. So remember, the report, you can actually read it on the internet. So I encourage you to take a look at it. But take some time to look at it. You're down and it's hard during the day, take a look at it and kind of reflect on some of the stuff you've done. So I encourage you to do that. So that said, just one big loud applause for you all. I'm sure you can clap more than that. So I've been here over a year and a half, and it's been a great year, outstanding. Again, back to board of directors, very supportive. And my thoughts and the direction we need to go as an organization. So we'll talk about the future, all right, real quick. So recently, our board of directors considered feedback from over 60 employees and adopted an updated mission statement and a vision that looks out to the year 2032. So the key is feedback from the employees. So when I was in the board meeting, actually had board members looking at comments from employees about what we need to do better, and clearly they took that very seriously. So our mission statement, Prince William County Service Authority protects public health and the environment by reliably providing clean, safe, dependable water and wastewater reclamation services to our community. Sums it up in great ways. So, question is, has our core mission changed? No, it hasn't. But words are important, and our new mission statement emphasizes that we protect public health and the environment, which is vital to our purpose. So, can't take that for granted. I think I would assume most in the room are familiar with the issues in Jackson, Mississippi. Raise your hand. Well, I'll tell you what's going on. Either you shy, raise your hand, if you want to talk about that. So, they were on a boil water advisory for months, and then they ran out of water supply. Folks had to boil water and things like that, and got on the national news. So it's an illustration of a number of things, lack of infrastructure, lack of expertise like we had in the room, funding, all these types of things, political, all that stuff, environmental justice issues. When you see that stuff on the news, you read about it, you can't take it for granted. What we do here, we do a great job. Just think about bring that up because, you know, when it hit, I got a couple of emails from employees saying, what can we do for Jackson, Mississippi? So talk to Don quite a bit about it, and we're looking out for the customers. So, you know, so incidentally, so I'm saying it because it kind of kept me on the rack for a little bit. I was requested to come to Jackson as utility executive to help them get back on their feet. So I'm going to put that out there, let you all know. It was a request from the EPA and U.S. Water. So I'm truly honored in that request. Definitely scary at the same time. I will be going probably within the next week. And what does that mean? It's temporary. So I'll be here and there for, I guess, 60 days off and on as we go to the end of the year. So I'm very confident leaving temporarily because you all do a great job. So I don't worry too much about me today. What am I going to do down there is why they request me is kind of my background down south in Atlanta. Their governance, the way they do things there, totally different than how we do it here. My experience in emergency management, also program management, that, you know, trying to see what kind of expertise they have there and their recommendations. So I will be trying to make my provide as much advice as I can, and hopefully we can make it work for them. All right, just FYI. Okay, so let's talk about our new vision at the Service Authority. The Prince William County Service Authority is a trusted public steward and nationally recognized model for performance excellence. We reflect the diverse and vibrant community we serve and nurture diversity, equity, and inclusion in relationships with our community, customers, businesses, and industry colleagues. So a lot of back and forth. The vision is what I'm for, and they have determined that the vision statement, which I think is great, emphasizes our role as trusted public stewards, our commitment to performance excellence, our commitment to nurture diversity, equity, and inclusion in all of our relationships, and our commitment to reflect the diverse and vibrant community we serve. So I imagine some of you know or don't know that Prince William County is one of the most diverse counties in the entire country. So we want to make sure our workforce is diverse also. But at the same time, I have to restate, I've talked to you all before in other meetings. My goal and purpose really is to hire the best people, have the best people here at the Service Authority, all right? So the conversation about diversity, equity, and inclusion can get a little uncomfortable. The thing is, I'm a believer, if it gets uncomfortable, we're on the right track. So continue to go down this journey. So what does that mean for everybody here? I think it's about questions individually. You may ask yourself, so what does that mean for me? And one of our board members, our last board member, she kind of summed it up, I think, in a very perfect way. We value our staff, regardless of the color of your skin, your gender, or how you identify. We value all of you. You are all are important. Couldn't have said it better. So as we go through this journey, we're all together. It's not of, we're not excluding anybody. My goal really is to make sure that everybody has an opportunity to come work here, compete for careers here. And again, we're going to hire the best people. So part of that division, our board decided to be, we had six areas of excellence, and it will continue to be six. They've been tweaked and retitled. First one is exceptional customer experience. Of course, customers come first. Workplace of choice. So you all come first. So it's not in order, but Dr. Jack, I slid it up there to the top to make sure they knew it was a priority for you all as our staff, our workforce. We want this place to be the workforce. your choice was that me. I want you to enjoy coming to work. I want you to enjoy working with your coworkers, and also have a purpose, set the purpose of unity, the things that I need. Also, area of excellence, environmental leadership, and community engagement, sustainable operations, financial stewardship, and continuous improvement and innovation. So during the coming weeks, you will see a series of emails describing each of these areas of excellence in more detail, okay? So what are the next steps in our strategic planning process? So the vision and the mission have been set. So now we have to get down to the day-to-day and that strategic plan. So we don't just go out and turn valves for no apparent reason. TV storylines, there's a method to it. You have to have a plan for it, and we're gonna get that started. So you'll receive an email tomorrow with a link to the vision document. Please take the time to read through our vision as it will guide us in the years to come. In October, over 60 employees will be involved in workshops to develop our strategic plan, which is a roadmap for how we will achieve the vision. So again, your feedback matters. Again, the board listens to you all and develop the vision statement, so your feedback matters. I'm not just saying that. I think people, mostly everybody, will probably remember me asking, how are you doing today? And that's really a real question. So how are you doing? I want to hear from you. So it's not a, I'm not going to tell you anything, I'm shy, he's not going to listen, and all that kind of stuff. So no, it's not the case. So your feedback is always welcome. So if reading the vision sparks ideas, please make sure to share those with your management team and me if you see. Most importantly, I hope you be able to see yourself and your work reflected in the new mission, vision, and areas of excellence, as each of you will play a key role in our future success. So, in closing, I know you guys want to have fun. I hope you share the pride I have and excitement I have, and you all hope to share that. Co-workers and workers. We have many reasons to celebrate. We have already accomplished that as an organization, and we have so much to look forward to with this new vision for the service authority. Also, I've got some plugs here, actually. Also, I want to remind you and encourage you to participate in our first diversity inclusion survey, which is underway through September 30th. Watch the emails about the survey and make your voice heard. So, I got the equipment going for over 100 folks have already responded. So great job. Great job. For those who have been watching my comments today by live stream, thank you for continuing to work while you are here. We appreciate you. For those who are here, please enjoy the rest of today's fall festival and the time with your co-workers. And I said that this is the last day of summer, right? So this is picking off fall. So thank you all. Great job, and go have some fun.